Welcome to this brief guide on how to share YouTube videos in Microsoft Teams. Sharing a YouTube video, or any other video for that matter, inside a Microsoft Teams meeting has always been a source of complaints for a lot of people due to stuttering frames or laggy audio. Well, today I'm going to show you how to correctly share a YouTube video to avoid all of that. Please note this works in both the desktop application and the web app as I'm demonstrating here. I have my attendee in the web app and I'm utilizing the desktop client. Normally, a lot of people would just use desktop sharing, but that creates that poor experience. So instead, we're gonna use the apps option at the top here in our menu system, and we're gonna select the YouTube app. If you do not already have it inside your client, you can search for it in the search box here. I'm going to add the YouTube app to the meeting simply by clicking on it. It'll take a few moments for it to be added to the meeting itself, but you'll notice here as the presenter, I get a little sidebar where I will be able to connect to what we call a live share session. It'll take a few moments to connect, but once done, we're going to have a search box. This search box is where we'll be able to either paste in either a direct YouTube link or search for a video using standard search terms. I already have a couple of videos ready, so I'm just going to paste in the URLs. Here you can see I have a couple of different options available to me. The option to watch together, which would directly initiate a video watching experience, but I'm going to add it to the queue just so I can show that you can add a couple of videos here and queue them all up back to back. So I'm going to paste in the second YouTube URL, and here's another video on how to choose which folder opens when you start Outlook, and I'm going to add that to the queue as well. Now that I've got both of my videos ready, I'm going to simply select watch together on the first video, and that will continue the live share session. You'll notice that the YouTube video is loading up locally in both the web app and in my desktop client. And from here, I have a couple of different options available to me that I can use to customize this experience a little bit more. They can be found in the settings cog down the bottom here. Opening the settings will give us a couple of things which are good to note, the first of which is group control. Toggling this on will allow attendees to pause and play the video as well. If you want to prohibit that, you can simply just toggle that option off. The other is smart audio. Smart audio will automatically lower the audio volume of the video should one of yourself or the attendees begin talking. In this case, I'm going to turn group control on just so you can see what that will look like. And now that we have our settings all configured, we're ready to start playing the video. Now you'll notice that the video is in the same spot for both users here. And once I click play from my end as the presenter, that will automatically initiate the video playing on the web app as well for the other attendees. Please note that the video is streaming locally on all of theirs. Playback is synchronized between all of us. So if I was to pause the video or play the video, it would do the same thing across other users. Because I have group control enabled, the attendee has the ability to pause the video for everyone as well. And it's worth noting that things such as closed captions are independent, and attendees can have their own particular closed captions enabled should they wish. So here you can see that my attendee in the web app has their subtitles turned on for English. However, me as the presenter, I don't currently have any subtitles enabled. Now, utilizing that settings cog, if I turn group control off, what you'll notice on the attendee side is that bar at the bottom that allows them to control the playback has now just disappeared. So it means that they don't accidentally try clicking on something that isn't going to work. Now, another example, I can simply just click on that watch together and initiate the second video in my queue. And you'll notice this experience is vastly superior to using desktop sharing, because things such as your specific options, such as closed captioning, is automatically remembered for each video, just like it would be if you were on the YouTube application in the web browser. And that is how you correctly share a YouTube video in your Microsoft Teams meeting. I hope you found this tip extremely useful, and I'll catch you in my next video. Thanks for watching. If you'd like to see more content like this, be sure to check out the channel. And if you like what you see, don't forget to hit that subscribe button.